Welcome to my CBSE English Teacher. Today, let's look at the line-by-line explanation of the third part of the chapter Indigo from Class 12 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of lessons from Classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. So let's move on to the video now. He was involved, he told the court, in a conflict of duties on the one hand, not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker, on the other hand, to render the humanitarian and national service for which he had come. He disregarded the order to live, not for want of respect for lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of conscience. So Gandhiji was summoned to the court and then he read out a statement pleading guilty. So he says that he was involved in a conflict of duties. That means in his mind he was in a great dilemma. What is a dilemma? He was not sure whether he was being a lawbreaker or whether he was helping his nation, the people of his nation. What is a big doubt? He said. He said that he did not want to set a bad example as a lawbreaker. Because at the moment he was summoned to the court because he was disobeying the law. They asked him to go away from that place and he said that he disobeyed the order. He said that he will not go back from that place. So in that way he was a lawbreaker. But at the same time he said that he did not want to do it because he was acting on behalf of his conscience. And his conscience always supported for the welfare of the people. Here welfare of the people he means the peasants. And the peasants are belonging to his own country. They were his own countrymen. He wanted to do something to support them. So that is why he says that he was involved in a conflict of duties. Both are his duties because he wanted to do some help to these peasants. And at the same time he also disobeyed the law. So he says that he was in a he had a conflict of duties in his mind. So he disregarded the order to leave not for the want of respect for lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of his conscience. So he says that though he was a lawbreaker, he was more related to the lawful authority, which was the voice of his conscience. He was saying that he wanted to do what his conscience told him was right. That is fight for his people. So this question is very important. Most of the time they ask this question during the board. And what is that question? What is the conflict of duties that Gandhiji was involved in? And then you have to write the answer like this. Gandhiji was in a dilemma because he did not want to be a lawbreaker by breaking the law and disobeying the law. And at the same time he wanted to help his peasants, and so he wanted to do according to what he felt was right for them. He wanted to help them out of their injustice. So this was the dilemma and conflict of duties that he was involved in. He asked the penalty due. The magistrate announced that he would pronounce the sentence after a 2-hour recess and asked Gandhi to furnish bail for those 120 minutes. Gandhi refused. The judge released him without bail. When the court reconvened, the judge said he would not deliver the judgment for several days. So Gandhiji wanted to know what penalty he had to pay because he was asked to be summoned to the court and he had disobeyed the law. Then the magistrate announced that he would pronounce the sentence after a 2-hour recess. What is pronouncing the sentence? That means reading out the judgment. So the magistrate or the judge said that he would read the statement or the punishment or whatever only after a 2-hour recess. Recess means break. So he wanted some 2 hours time and asked Gandhi to furnish bail for those 120 minutes. And he told Gandhi that he has to get a bail for 120 minutes. So what is a bail? Bail is a short release, you know, by paying some amount of money. So here the judge told Gandhi that he has to pay some money if he had to be free for those 2 hours. And so, but Gandhiji refused. He said that I will not pay any money. So the judge released him without bail. But what did the judge do? He said that, okay, you are free to be there for 2 hours. You don't have to pay any money. When the court reconvened, what is the meaning of reconvened? So they had a short break for 2 hours and after that they gathered once again. So once again gathering is reconvening. And after the court, you know, after reconvened, what did the judge say? The judge said that he would not deliver the judgment for several days. So he said that he has postponed the judgment and only after some days he is going to deliver the judgment for Gandhi. Meanwhile, he allowed Gandhi to remain at liberty. Rajendra Prasad, Brij Kishore Babu, Maulana Mazrul Haq and several other prominent lawyers had arrived from Bihar. They conferred with Gandhi. What would they do if he was sentenced to prison? Gandhi asked. Why? The senior lawyer replied. They had come to advise and help him. If he went to the jail, there would be nobody to advise and they would go home. So now what happened? Now Gandhi was free because the judge said that he would read the sentence only after a few days. So he was at liberty. That means he was free. And now meanwhile what happened? Rajendra Prasad came with many prominent lawyers. Prominent means those who are famous in that area. So who were they? Brij Kishore Babu, Maulana Mazrul Haq, etc. So all these lawyers came to Bihar and then they conferred with Gandhi. What is conferring? They met him and together they had a meeting. They all spoke with Gandhi. What would they do if he was sentenced to prison? Gandhi asked. So when they all met, Gandhi asked them one question. What is the question he asked? Okay, if I am sent to jail, what will you do? Why? The senior lawyer replied. They had come to advise and help him. If he went to jail, there would be nobody to advise and they would go home. So what did one of the lawyers, senior lawyers say? He said that, okay, we actually came here to help you and advise you. But if you go to jail, what will we do? There'll be nobody to advise and help. So we'll all go back home. So this was the reply given by one of the senior lawyers. What about the injustice to the sharecroppers? Gandhi demanded. The lawyers withdrew to consult. Rajendra Prasad had recorded the upshot of their consultations. They thought among themselves that Gandhi was totally a stranger and yet he was prepared to go to prison for the sake of the peasants. If they, on the other hand, being not only residents of the adjoining districts but also those who claim to have served these peasants should go home, it would be a shameful desertion. So Gandhi felt really bad when he heard one of the senior lawyers say that they would all go home if Gandhi went to jail. So he immediately asked them, then what will happen to the sharecroppers and the injustice? Who is going to help them? He asked them. So immediately the lawyers withdrew to consult. That means all the lawyers together, they gathered and they started talking among themselves. So what did they say? Rajendra Prasad had recorded the upshot of their consultations. That means he had recorded the most important points. So what is that they spoke? They said that, see, Gandhi was a total stranger. He is coming from somewhere and he is ready to help the sharecroppers and even go to jail for them. But all these lawyers, they are all from same or the next adjoining, means the next districts, and some of these lawyers have even fought the cases for these peasants. And if these people are going to go home, then it will be a shameful desertion. Desertion means leaving that place. So it will be very shameful if these strangers, if these lawyers just went back home if Gandhiji was arrested. They accordingly went back to Gandhi and told him that they were ready to follow him into jail. The battle of Champaran is won, he exclaimed. Then he took a piece of paper and divided the group into pairs and put down the order in which each pair was to court arrest. Several days later, Gandhi received a written communication from the magistrate informing him that the lieutenant governor of the province had ordered the case to be dropped. So when the lawyers had a discussion, they understood that it would be shameful to go back home without helping Gandhi, who was a stranger and still was ready to go to jail for the sharecroppers. So they decided that they would follow him to jail. So what they did, they went back to Gandhi and told him that they were ready to follow him to jail. So immediately Gandhi became very happy and he exclaimed, "The battle of Champaran is won." That means he says that because the lawyers agreed to go to jail with him, he says that the battle of Champaran is won. Then he took a piece of paper and divided the group into pairs. Then what he did, he called all these lawyers close to him. On a piece of paper, he wrote down the names of all the lawyers in pairs. Then he said that in this order, you all have to go and get yourself arrested if I go to jail. But then that was not necessary because he got a letter from the magistrate informing him that the case against him has been dropped by the lieutenant governor and that he was free now. Civil disobedience had triumphed the first time in modern India. Gandhi and the lawyers now proceeded to conduct a far-flung inquiry into the grievances of the farmers. Depositions by about 10,000 peasants were written down and notes made on the other evidence. Documents were collected. The whole area throbbed with activity of investigators and the vehement protests of the landlords. So here Gandhi says that civil disobedience had triumphed for the first time in modern India. What is civil disobedience? Disobeying the law by the people. Civil means by the people. So for the first time Gandhi disobeyed the law by the British. And this he also had a lot of people to support him for this thing. There were lawyers and other peasants. They all gathered in front of the court. So the whole thing was able to get the case away from Gandhi. The case against him was cancelled. So they say that the civil disobedience had triumphed for the first time. So Gandhi and the lawyers now proceeded to conduct a far-flung inquiry into the grievances of the farmers. So now Gandhi was free. So he along with the other lawyers, what did they do? They decided to collect all the evidences by looking into the grievances. Grievances means sad stories or sad plight of the farmers. So he wanted to help them. So he conducted a lot of inquiry into these farmers' conditions. So he went and met a lot of farmers and asked them a lot of questions and the type of suffering they are undergoing. Depositions by 10,000 peasants were written down and notes made on other evidence. What is depositions? Depositions means with evidences. So more than 10,000 peasants were met. He went to them and he wrote down what all he could get about the injustice that they were suffering. So he collected a lot of evidence and documents were collected. The whole area throbbed with activity. That means the whole of Champaran was fully active because Gandhi and other lawyers were going and meeting all the peasants and talking to them and trying to find out how they were suffering. And the vehement protests of the landlords. So not only the activity was from the peasant side, it's also from the landlords. What is vehement protest? They showed their strong protest because Gandhiji was actually collecting evidence against them. In June, Gandhi was summoned to Sir Edward Gate, the lieutenant governor. Before he went, he met leading associates and again laid detailed plans for civil disobedience if he should not return. Gandhi had 4 protracted interviews with the lieutenant governor, who as a result appointed an official commission of inquiry into the Indigo sharecropper situation. The commission consisted of landlords, government officials and Gandhi as the sole representative of the peasants. Now Gandhi and the other lawyers were collecting evidence against the British. So the lieutenant governor, Sir Edward Gate, called Gandhi to go and meet him. Before he went, he met the leading associates and again laid detailed plans. So when he was going to meet Sir Edward Gate, the lieutenant governor, what Gandhi said, again he called all the prominent lawyers and he told them his plans. He gave them some plans. What he said, okay, if I'm going to meet him, if I did not return, you should go and get yourself arrested. So this is what he told them. Gandhi had 4 protracted interviews with the Lieutenant Governor. So what is protracted interview? Protracted means longer than usual. So he had very long interviews with the Lieutenant Governor. So after the interviews, he appointed an official commission for inquiry into the sharecropper's condition. Official commission means a group that is going to inquire into the condition of the indigo sharecroppers. The commission consisted of landlords, government officials, and Gandhi as the sole representative of the peasants. So that commission had on their behalf landlords and other government officials, and Gandhi was a single person who represented the peasants or the Indian farmers. Gandhi remained in Champaran for an initial uninterrupted period of 7 months, and then again for several shorter visits. The visit undertaken casually on the entreaty of an unlettered peasant in the expectation that it would last a few days occupied almost a year of Gandhi's life. The official inquiry assembled a crushing mountain of evidence against the big planters, and when they saw that this, they agreed in principle to make refunds to the peasants. So Gandhi remained in Champaran for about 7 months, and he also had many short visits to Champaran in order to take care of this issue of the sharecroppers. And what is the truth is that just because of this unlettered peasant, what do you mean by unlettered peasant? That means an illiterate farmer. Who is this illiterate farmer? It is Rajkumar Shukla. And because of his entreaty, what is entreaty? A humble request. So he only requested Gandhi humbly to come to Champaran and look into the issue of this sharecroppers. So what they say is, just because of this humble request made by an unlettered peasant, it took at least 1 year for Gandhiji to stay in Champaran. Like, it took at least, he stayed there at least for 1 year, and he had to deal with the sharecroppers issue. So what the official inquiry, after a lot of inquiry, they got a huge amount of evidence against the big planters. Who are the big planters? The big planters are none other than the British landlords. And when they saw that there was a huge, you know, evidence against them, they agreed to pay back the money to the peasants or the farmers. But how much must we pay? They asked Gandhi. They thought that he would demand repayment in full, the money which they had illegally and deceitfully extorted from the sharecroppers. He asked only 50%. There he seemed adamant, writes Reverend J.Z. Hodge, a British missionary in Champaran, who observed the entire episode at close range. So the landlords understood that there was a big or a huge amount of evidence collected against them by Gandhi. So they agreed to repay the peasants whatever money they collected from them. But then they had a doubt. They wanted to know how much should we pay. So they asked Gandhi, and they also thought that Gandhi would demand full 100% payment should be done to them. And this money they had actually extracted from these farmers illegally and deceitfully. Illegally means not in a lawful manner, and deceitfully means by cheating them. Extorted means actually literally drag the money out of them, just force them to pay the money. So they were not sure how much they should pay back to the sharecrop. So they asked Gandhi how much should they pay. So he said that they have to pay 50% of the money whatever they had extracted. There he seemed adamant, writes Reverend J.Z. Hodge, a British missionary. So missionary is a person who comes to do some, you know, service to the people. So this man, Reverend Hodge, he was talking about Gandhi, what he did. He says that he was adamant and he was very sure, and he did not want to change his mind. He actually asked the landlords to pay 50% of the money that he had, you know, that they had taken from the farmers. So this missionary was a man who was able to observe the whole Champaran episode from close range. That means he saw what all happened there. And he says that Gandhiji was stubborn and strict, and he said that he should, or the British landlord should, pay 50% of the money to the sharecroppers. I hope you like today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English Teacher. Like, share, comment and subscribe. The next part of the lesson will be done in my next video. Thank you for watching.